Okay, so again, guys, if you wanted to show yourselves in this recording, I'll be uploading this, guys. Ha? Huwag kayo mahiya. Okay lang po. Baka matulog kayo sa isang estudyante ko. Anyway, so this will be our last topic, which is on the following content. First is we'll have the modulo arithmetic. And then afterwards, we'll have a little application of modulo arithmetic. And then the last part will be on a short discussion also of cryptography. Puro short lang. We'll try to finish this up in almost 1 hour. Okay, so to start with, let's start with the modulo arithmetic. So sabi dito, in mathematics, modular arithmetic or sometimes called clock arithmetic. It's a system of arithmetic for integers. So again, integers, so yung mga whole numbers natin together with the negatives. Okay? Where numbers wrap around after they reach a certain value, the modulus. Okay? So just like if you look into this clock, guys, itong relo natin, di ba? Pag nagkuha tayo ng relo, magsimula tayo sa 1, 2, 3. Actually, sa 0 yan, di ba? Or 12. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then after the 12, hindi tayo magsasabing 13th o'clock, di ba? Balik tayo sa 1. Okay? Kaya ganun, tinatawag si modular arithmetic as what we call clock arithmetic. So parang after a certain number, we call it the modulus, babalik siya sa 1. Okay, malinaw po. Hello, malinaw po ba?
Yes,
Okay. The modular arithmetic was started or was introduced by a very great mathematician, which you have already seen in our graph theory class. We have Mr. Leonhard Euler. So he pioneered the modern approach to congruence in around 1750, which he introduced the idea of this topic, which is the idea of congruence modulo number n or modulo n. And then later on, it was enhanced by a very profound mathematician also in the name of Carl Friedrich Gauss in his book published in 1801. Okay? So itong dalawang utak na to ang nagpasimuno ng modular arithmetic. Now, let's define modulo n or the modulo n. So we say that two integers a and b are congruent modulo n. Okay, so important yung dalawang at tatlong numbers natin dito. We have a, b, and then n. Okay, of course n is a natural number. Ibig sabihin positive, or positive integer. Okay, if I have a minus b, in other words, if I subtract a and b, notice sabi dito, and I divide it by n, it should be an integer. In other words, you can say na yung ating difference ng a and b, it should be divisible by n. Okay? So in this case, we write it as a, yung tatlong linya na yan, ang pagbasa nito ay a congruent to b mod n or modulo n. Okay? And then your small n is called the modulus. Okay? And this statement, the whole statement is called congruence. Okay, malinaw po ba? Okay, let's check. Have an example. Kunwari, I have, I can say na, kunwari, I have, say, 25. This is congruent to, say, 5 mod 10. Okay? Tama ba? I can do that. Kasi notice, if I subtract 25 and then 5, what happens? 25 minus 5 is 1. Anyone? Okay, this is 20. Okay, ang 20 ba divisible by 10?
Yes, sir.
Yes, po.
Notice, if I divide 20 by 10, this is equal to 2, which is an integer. So, ibig sabihin, si 20 minus 5, 25 minus 5 is divisible by 10. So, we have a congruence. Okay? Malinaw?
Yes, please.
Okay. Another one, kunwari, I have, say, is 25 congruent to 4 mod 7? Pwede ko bang sabihin yan? Ang 25 congruent to 4 mod 7?
Apo.
Sir.
Okay,
yes. Yes po.
Kasi, bakit? Anyone?
25. Ay.
Go
7,
ahead.
8.
Sige, sige.
Divisible po yung
divisible.
21.
Sino kaya? Sige, Adam. Ikaw muna, Adam.
Sir, 25 minus 4, sir. Was 21. Divisible na po siya sa 7.
Okay, very good. So that's why we have a congruence here, right? Tama. So also, pwede ko rin sabihin, kunwari I have, say, 25. Pwede kong sabihin na it is not congruent to 5 mod 7, right? Tama ba? Hindi naman siya congruent sa 5 mod 7 kasi if you subtract 5 by 25 by 5, it is not divisible by 7 anymore. Okay? Malinaw?
Yes,
so malinaw, malinaw na po yung yes, statement natin na A is congruent to B mod N. So pag may nakita kayong ganyan, ibig sabihin, ang ginagawa lang natin dito is we are subtracting B from A or B from A and then the difference should be divisible by N. Okay? Take note, pag sinabi natin congruence or divisibility, pwedeng yung negative, di ba? Ang negative number, pwede pa rin i-divide ng positive N. So, walang problema yan. Kahit alin dyan ang mas malaki. Okay? Malinaw? Okay. Let's have this statement. Okay, let's say, gawin natin para hindi tayo magulo. Gawin natin itong Thursday na. Kasi Thursday ngayon, di ba? Para hindi tayo magulo. Okay, today is Thursday, right? To determine the days of the week, 16 days from now, we observe that 14 days from now, the day will also be Thursday, right? Basta natin to kasi pang... Tama? Yan. Tama ba, guys? Hello? Are you still
yes,
there?
Po, yes, po, sir.
In other words, actually, every 7 days, nauulit lang yung araw. Tama? Kung ngayon ay Thursday, in 7 days, it will be Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Ay, Tuesday, Wednesday, di ba? And then on the next day, after the 7th day, that would now be Thursday again, right? Tama ba? So ulit,
tama.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, okay, Wednesday. And then on the 7th day, that would still be Thursday, right? So every 7th day, nauulit lang. So we can actually use modulo 7 to identify the day of the week in a certain number of days. So in this case, if I say, if I try to determine the day 16 days from now, di ba? 16 days from now, if we try to use congruence here, 16 is congruent, okay, to 2 mod 7, right? Hello? Tama po?
Yes,
yes, sir. Yes, po.
Okay. So dahil si 2 ay congruent sa 16, so ibig sabihin, yung 16 days na to would have the same number of days dun sa 2. Okay? And since 2 signifies 2 days after Thursday in this case, okay? So ibig sabihin, Thursday, 2 days after Thursday, it will be Saturday. Right? Can you follow?
Yes, po.
Okay, gawin natin medyo komplikado. How about, say, 100 days from now? Okay, from now. What will be the day 100 days from now? So using modulo again, so we need to get 100 and then how is this congruent to 7? So in other words, this is congruent to blank mod 7, right? So what will be the... How did what will be the remainder now when we divide 100 by 7? Anyone? Hello?
Two po.
Okay, are you sure?
Two po. Two.
So again, if you divide 100 by 7, paano yung nakuha si 2?
Minus lang po siya. 100.
Okay. So, notice, okay, yeah. it's 14, remainder 2, right? So
yes,
we have,
sir.
This is 2. So if you say 100 days from now, what will be the day? Okay, so it will also be Saturday, right? Can you follow? Malina po ba?
Yes po, yes po.
Okay, how about say 200 days from now? 200 days from now, 200 is congruent to what? Mod 7. Tatawag na ako dito. Can I call someone? Mr. Cuenca, are you there? Melvin, anong yes, sagot dito?
₱196 po, remainder 4 po, sir.
Okay, so the remainder is 4. So yun yung kailangan natin yung remainder 4, right? Tama? Okay.
Yes po.
Okay, thank you. Now, if 200 is congruent to 4 mod 7, what will be the day 200 days from now? Ay, tawag ulit ako. Let's have Miss Ramos, are you there? Sophia? Sophia? Andiyan ka ba? Miss Francine Ramos, are you there? Calling Sophia Francine Ramos. Yes, Jonard, you're raising your hand.
Monday, sir.
Monday? Okay. Let me guess. Doon lang guess dito. Okay, check
yeah,
natin.
Monday pa, Monday.
Monday. Check na natin. So since it's Thursday, 4 days from now, so that would be Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Okay, that would be Monday, right? So 200 days from now, it will be Monday. Okay? Now, let's try this one. Ito naman. July 4, 2010 was a Sunday. Ang tanong, what day of the week is July 4, 2018? So, this one is also a very simple, has a simple trick. So, from July 4, 2010 to July 4, 2018, how many years did it pass?
Eight years.
That would be 8 years, right? So, in 8 years, so in for a year, that would be 365, right? So, 365. So, we multiply this by 8. Okay. So, the result will be 2920, right? Tama po ba? Tama?
Yes,
sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Leap year, sir. Okay, very good. Very good observation. There were actually 2 leap years, tama?
Opo, sir.
Okay, 2012 and then 2016. So there are 2 leap years. So magdadagdag tayo dito ng dalawang, multiply natin ito, ito add natin ito ng 2. So this will have 2922, right? Tama ba?
Opo.
Okay, so there are 2,922 days from July 4, 2010 to July 4, 2018. So ang tanong, what will be the day on July 4, 2018? So we again get modulo 7, right? Okay. So in other words, let's divide 2922 by 7 and then get the remainder. So this will be 4, so 28. That would be 1, right? And then 12 divided by 7 is 1. That would be 7. 12 minus 7 is? What's 12 minus 7? What's the answer, Kuya?
5 po.
Okay, very good. Ang pamangkin kong grade 2 dito, ha? And then bring down 2. So 52 divided by 7. So what's the nearest we have? What's the answer? I think that's 7, right?
7.
7 times 7? 49. Okay, 49. And notice we have a remainder, which is, what's a remainder?
4.
4. Hmm? 4.
4. 4 ba yan?
3 po.
Di ba 3?
3 po, 3. 3 po, sir.
Okay, so 52 minus 49 is 3, right? Okay. So the remainder is 3, so we now say that 29, 22 is congruent to 3 mod 7, right?
Yes.
Okay, so since it's congruent to 3 mod 7, so we say BN, July, when July 4, 2010 was a Sunday, July 4, 2018 is?
Wednesday.
Okay, very good. So this one is Wednesday. Okay. Malinaw?
Yes po. Yes,
yes po, sir.
Let's now proceed with modulo operations. So modulo operations or modulo arithmetic, we will just be considering the remainders, diba? If you notice, we've been doing remainders. So ang Zn natin is from 0 to n minus 1. So ang, kunwari, ang n natin ay 5. This would be up to 5 minus 1. So magiging 4. Just like this, for example. If I have this, look at this. Z3, that would be 0 to 2. Z5 is 0 to 4. Z8, 0 to 7, and so on. Basta minus 1 lagi. In other words, if I have to get the congruence of a certain number, okay, ang gagawin ko lang is I'll just be getting the remainder. That will be, the remainders will be from 0 to n minus 1 lang. Okay, malina po? Okay po?
Yes, please.
So, in modular arithmetic, para makuha natin or simplify that, what we have to do is to, in performing this, ang gagawin lang natin is, we will try to perform the usual arithmetic and then later on, we'll try to get the remainder. Okay? So, for example, if I try to get the modulo n, say, kunwari, I try to do addition modulo n, narito, 23 plus 38 modulo 12. So I just simply add 23 and then 38. Ang sagot natin would be 61, right? Tama po?
Yes po.
Okay. Apo. And then if I divide 61 by 12, it will be 5 and the remainder is 1. So I can say na this one will be 1. So I cannot say that this is just congruent to 1. Mod. Okay, or congruent to 1. Got it? Malinaw po?
Yes, po, sir.
So, again, ang gagawin lang natin, the usual. Kapag nag-add, you just have to add the usual and then afterwards, you just get the remaining. Kapag nag-subtract naman tayo, nangyari itong let's have letter A. So, if you look into letter A, 33 minus 16, ang result ay 17, right? And the result is positive. So pag positive, the usual thing that we just like that we just did dun sa addition, parang ganun lang din. So we just get the we just divide and then get the remainder. So if we divide 17 by 6, ang sagot ay 2, okay, right? And the remainder is 5. So that's why 33 minus 16 mod 6 is 5. Okay? Did you get that?
Yes po.
Yes po.
Okay. Now, ang problema naman tulad dito sa pangalawa, ang sagot, if I have to get the difference of 14 minus 27, ano yung sagot? 14 minus 27, this one is? It's actually congruent to negative 13. Right? Medyo may problema tayo pag negative. Pero parehas pa rin. We still have to divide and then get the remainder. So when we divide negative 13 by 5, what's the remainder?
Negative 2.6 po.
Mm-hmm.
3.3. Remainder
pa. Okay. Remainder ay?
3.
Negative 3, right? So this will be congruent to negative 3 mod 5, right? Tama?
Yes po.
Yes, sir.
Okay. But sabi natin, ang sagot laging dapat positive from 0 to n minus 1. So gagawin lang natin itong positive, magdaad lang tayo ng n. So negative 3 plus 5, ano yung sagot? Okay, so this will just be congruent to 2. So ito na yung sagot. Got it?
Yes po.
Okay, so pag negative, ang gagawin natin, the usual, we get the remainder. But afterwards, we have to make it positive. Okay? Malinaw po? Isa pang example?
Yes, sir.
Okay, unari. I have... say 25 minus 98 and then mod... say 8, for example. Ilan to? So this is congruent to 1. So this is negative 73, right? Okay, mod 8. So this is 73. So this is negative 1, right? Tama ba? Tama ba, guys? 73 is 72. 72 is 9 times 8. So 72. So ang kulang ay negative 1. So this is congruent to negative 1 mod 8, right? Malinaw? Paano na ako si negative 1?
Apo, sir.
Apo, sir. Apo.
Okay. Pero negative. So gawin natin positive. So magdadagdag na lang tayo ng 8. Right? So this will now be congruent to 7. Okay? Malinaw po?
Yes po.
Opo, sir.
Okay. Or you can actually consider parang yung negative 73, gawin mo lang siyang positive. Paano mo siya gagawing positive? Mag-a-add ka ng mag-a-add lang nitong ating n hanggang sa maging positive siya. So kung tinry mo yung negative 70, mag-add ka lang ng 8 ng mag-8, mag-add ka ng 8 dyan. Ang pinakaunang positive niyan will be this. Okay? Okay po? Okay. So the same process natin dun sa multiplication sa division. So pag nag-multiply ka at nag-divide, dapat kapag nag-positive, ganun pa rin, we put it into from 0 to n minus 1 or get the remainder. Same thing kapag nag-multiply tayo at nag-negative yung lumabas. So ganun din ang gagawin natin, just like this. Okay?
That's fine.
Okay. Let us now proceed with... I have some exercises here. If you want, you can copy this and then maybe you can do this at home. Pwede nyo screenshot siguro. Or later on, panoorin nyo lang yung exercise na ay itong recording na to and then gawin nyo na lang. Okay? Iwan ko na lang to sa inyo. Okay lang po ba?
Yes, sir. Ako po.
Okay. Let's now proceed with the application. Okay, I have here three applications that we can use for modular arithmetic. The first one is by the use or using the check digit of your ISBN and then your PC. Ano yung ISBN? ISBN is short for or an acronym for International Standard Book Number. Okay, ito yung mga number na nakikita natin sa mga libro. At yung UPC naman, ang tawag natin doon ay ito yung Universal Product Code. Yung nakikita natin mga barcode natin sa mga gamit natin. Okay? So, si ISBN, usually 13 digit yan. And the first three digits are 978. The next digits indicates the country. Okay? And sometimes one for, or zero and sometimes one for books written in English. The next 2 to 7 indicate the publisher. The next group of digits indicates the title of the book. And the last digit, the 13th one. Ito yung importante natin is the check digit. So, how do we consider the check digit? Ang gagawin lang natin dito is, after labeling all the digits by D1 up to D12, okay, yung 13th digit, we call it D13. It should follow this formula. That D13 should be congruent to 10 minus D plus 3 times D2 plus D3 plus 3 times D4 and so on. Hanggang dito, mod 10. Okay? So if it follows this formula, then we have a correct ISBN most probably. Okay? Well, most probably kasi siyempre pwede pa rin magkamali. But kapag hindi siya naging correct, automatic mali talaga yung ISBN na yan. Okay, let's have an example this one. Okay? Ready po ba? Andyan pa po ba kayo?
Dito pa, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Kala ko iniwan nyo na naman ako tulad ng pag-iwan niya sa akin.
Sir, broken ka?
Oo naman. Charot. Okay, let's follow the, let's try to use the formula. So, 10, okay, minus, okay. So, sabi doon sa formula, lahat ng mga even digits, di ba? So, yung unang, tawag dito, unang digit, parang imagine ito yung D1, D2, D3. Can you follow? D4, 5, D6, D7, D8, D9, D10, D11, D12. So, ang D13 natin ay yung 4. Yung check digit na. Can you follow? Halino po? Okay. So, sabi dun sa kwan natin, dapat we have 10 minus the first digit which is 9 plus yung second digit or lahat ng even multiply natin ng 3. So, 3 times 7 plus 8. Nakasusundan po ba? Okay, plus 3 times 0 plus 3 plus 3 times 9. Can you follow, guys? Paano ko nakukuha to? Hello? Okay. Plus, and then we have 5. And then plus 3 times 8. And then plus 2. And then plus 3 times 5 plus 1 and finally 3 times 7. Okay?
Sir, ba't po yung 8 po? 3 times 8.
Okay, tingnan natin ha. Di ba D1 is your D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8, D9, D10, D11, and then this is D12. Okay? So, imumultiply lang natin ng 3 lahat ng mga even digits natin. Lahat ng mga even. Di ba may mga times 3 tayo dyan? Napansin nyo? Okay? Yung mga even digits natin dito ay 7, 0, 9, 8, 5, and then 7. Can you follow?
Yes, for sure.
Okay, so okay, meron tayo. And then if we try to get mod 10. Don't forget mod 10. Okay? So pag sinumpute natin yan, this is, ano yung, nakumpute nyo ba ito? Ito napakahabang may multiply, may times 3. Itong sum na to. Can you try computing, guys? Ano yung value? Ano sagot? Hello? Ano pa ba? Hello po? May kausap pa po ba?
Wait lang po, sir. Compute po, sir.
Sige, sige. Okay, sige. Sorry naman. Masyado lang akong atat. Okay, tapos na. Tapos na. Uy, andito na pala yung aking pamangkin na with honors. Shout out nga pala sa pamangkin ko na with honors. Binigyan sila kanina ng award. Na all with honors. Ano na? Okay na po ba? Ano yung sagot? Hello? Woohoo.
Lahat ba, sir?
Ano sagot?
6 ata, sir.
Ano yung 6? So, this will be, itong mahabang sum na to, ano nakuha nito? Dito, ito. Anong value nakuha nyo dito? This one is, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, 136 yan. So this is 10 minus 136. Okay? Mod 10, right? Did you get the same number? The same value?
Yes.
Okay.
So 10 minus 136, this one is congruent to negative 126. Ay, sorry. 126 nga, 128 na lang sinulat. Okay, let's erase. So 126 mod 10, right? Can you follow? And negative 126 mod 10 is just congruent to negative 6 mod 10, right? Tama po?
Yes, please, sir.
Okay, and negative 6 mod 10 is what?
4.
Okay. Okay, which is congruent to 4. Okay, which is our check digit here, right? Got it?
Yes, po, sir.
Okay, notice, dito sa pangalawa, nagpalit lang ng dalawa at hindi na yan magiging correct. Kasi kung titingnan natin, 2 and then 8, asan yan? Ito yan, di ba? Ito. Ito. Right? Pag pinagpalit natin yan, magiging 3 times 2 plus 8 na siya. And this will be 3 times 2 plus 8, parang magiging 14, right? Tama, 14. Tama ba? E, itong previous, 3 times 8 ay 24 plus 2. So, 26 yan, di ba? So, ang difference itong dalawa ay 12, right? Tama ba? Kapag ito ang ginamit natin, magiging 10 minus, instead of 136, minus 12. So, minus 124 na yun, right? Mod 10. And this will now be congruent to negative 114 mod 10. Which is congruent to negative 4 mod 10. Which is now congruent to 6, which is not the same as your check digit here. Can you follow?
Yes, please.
So that's why this ISBN now is an incorrect ISBN. Okay? Nakuha po? Hello? Okay. So, this one naman, halos pares lang ito. So, sa UPC naman, ang ginagawa dito, medyo may konting pagkakaiba lang. Si UPC kasi, 12 digits lang siya. So, ang 12th digit yun yung magiging check digit natin. Tapos, dun sa ISBN, di ba, yung even digit ang magiging mumultiply natin sa 3. Dito yung mga add. Okay? Can you follow? And the same process. And yung last digit should be congruent to this arithmetic mod 10 also. So halos ganun din. Malinaw po? So do we need to give you an example on this? Hello? Hello po? Ano ba yan? Can I have a react, guys? Yung para malaman ko kung naandyan pa kayo. Please.
Nandito pa po, sir. Nandito pa po.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sige. Pa-react nga, guys, dyan. Mag-react
nga. Yes, sir. Dyan. Yes, po.
Yan. Sino pa? Yan. Pa-react nga po para ma... Check ko lang na naandyan pa kayo. Baka wala na akong kausap dito.
Hello, sir. Sir, miss ko na siya, sir.
Oh, na-all. Na-all na may nakaka-miss. Okay, ayan. At least may mga nagre-react pa naman. Buhay pa naman kayo dyan. Thank you. Okay, so do we need to have an example on this? Sorry, very similar lang to dun sa ISBN. Nagpalit lang itong mga positions. Okay? Okay, can we now move to the next one?
Yes, hello. Sir.
Yes, please.
Okay, sige. The last example natin, or rather last application na pwede natin i-consider is what we call the loan algorithm. Si Loon algorithm is actually, sabi dito, is it's used to write the credit card numbers. Okay? So how do we determine if a credit card number is valid? They usually use the Loon algorithm. Okay? Paano siya ginagamit? So si credit card usually meron siyang 13 to 16 digits na numbers, okay? Okay, usually si itong first four digits natin o 1 to 4 digits usually identify the card user. Okay, ito yung ating mga prefixes na to. Si MasterCard usually 51 to 55 ang gamit nila, si Visa ay 4. Ito hindi ko masyado tong alam, pero si American Express daw 34 or 37, si Discover daw 6011. Okay? At ito yung number of digits nila. So paano ginagawa si Loon algorithm? Okay, I'll just show you with an example para mas madali nating mag-gets. Okay? So, consider this one, this example. This one, let's say this if this one is a valid credit card number or follows the Loon algorithm. So, paano gagawin? Si Loon algorithm, malinaw po ba? Can I continue? Andiyan
yes,
pa ba?
Sir.
Okay. So, ang gagawin,
yes,
yung mga add digits natin, idodouble lang natin. Yung una, pangatlo, panglima, pangpito, and so on. Lahat ng mga even digits na, ay sorry, add digits, ita times 2 lang natin. So yung 5, times 2 natin, kaya nagkaroon ng 10. Si 2 na to, as is lang. Kopya lang. Malinaw?
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir.
Okay, and then 3 yes, times po. 2, kaya meron tayong 6. Copy ulit si 4, times 2 si 8, kaya 16. Copy si 2, 1 times 2 is 2. Si 3 ay 3 ulit. 3 multiply sa 2. Copy yung sumunod, double yung pangalawa. Copy yung sumunod, double yung dalawa. Copy yung sumunod, double yung pangalawa. Tapos, copy yung huli. Okay, malinaw?
Yes, po sir.
Okay. Pagkatapos, i-add lang natin yung mga digits. Pag doubling digits yan, add mo yung 1 plus 0. Just like this. So 1 plus 0 plus 2 plus so on so forth. I-add lang yung mga digits. Tapos, kapag in-add mo yung digits, in this case, ang sagot daw dito ay 60. Okay? Malinaw?
Yes po.
Yes po.
Okay. Sabi yes, si kay Loon algorithm, para maging valid, dapat itong sum na to ng mga digits na to ay dapat congruent sa 0 mod 10. Okay, pag if it's not congruent to 0 mod 10, this number will not be a valid credit card number. Or this credit card, this number does not follow the Loon algorithm, which is not a valid credit card number in that case. Malinaw po ba?
Yes, sir.
Yes, po, sir.
Okay. So dahil dito, we know 60 is divisible by 10, so it will be congruent to 0 mod 10, so this one is a valid credit card number. Okay? So, hindi tayo basta-basta pwedeng magpatsamba ng credit card. Medyo masalimuot, di ba, yung paano mag-identify ng credit card. Okay, let's try. Mali mo, makatsamba tayo. Can I have an example? Kunwari, let's try magpatsamba ng number. Let's start with, anong gusto yung number? Let's start with 52, for example. Sige nga, let's try to have 16 digits. And then try to use the Loon algorithm. Anyone? Can you supply me numbers? Sige, random na lang kayo magsalita para mayroon ako
marinig.
9. 69, sir.
9.
8.
5. 8.
17.
3.
1, 7. Tapos 3.
4.
15. O, apat pa. 4.
4.
O, 4.
69 ulit, sir.
Okay, tapos na. So, sa Loon algorithm, i-double mo na yung una at saka yung lahat ng add digits, di ba? So, hindi mga add numbers ha, yung pang-add positions. So, si 5, i-multiply natin sa 2, kaya mag-aaroon ako dito ng 10. Copy si 2. Nasusundan po ba? 12, 9. Nasusundan po?
Yes, po, sir.
Okay, and then 10. Ano sunod?
8.
Okay, very good. 8, next.
2.
Okay, very good. Next.
7.
7.
Okay, next.
6.
Okay, next.
3.
Next?
Two.
Two.
Okay. Tapos?
Five.
Five.
Eight.
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 Four.
Four.
Two.
Two.
Two. One. Two. Ay, wala na. So, pala.
Okay, natin. So, one. One plus zero is one. Ito, three. Four. Six. Plus nine. 15. 16.
55.
So this will give you 65. But notice this is not congruent to 0 mod 10, right? So ibig sabihin ito ay invalid. Credit card now. Can you follow?
Opo, sir.
Yes, po, sir. Yes, yes, sir.
Okay, so ganon. So una, ginawa natin kanina, we tried to introduce the modulo n or the congruence modulo n, and then we tried to use that in identifying days. And afterwards, we had the application by using the check digit on ISB and UPC, and now we have your credit card number using the Loon algorithm. Ang next nating topic, guys, is cryptology. This one is a very short course again. That uses modulo n again, or the congruence modulo n. Okay, now, cryptology, sabi dito, is the study of making or breaking codes. Okay, and breaking na naman, may break up na naman, Diyos ko Lord. Lagi na lang panakit tong discussion. Okay, so usually kasi para safe yung ating messages, noong unang panahon pa, ginagawa na yung cryptology. They tried to put their messages in codes para hindi agad-agad naiintindihan ng iba. Okay? The process of writing plain text, or alam natin kapag plain text is, siguro alam niyo kasi BSIT, di ba? Pag plain text, yung the usual text na nababasa natin. Okay? Cipher text naman is when we put it in code. Ito na yung magiging itsura niya. Okay? Malinaw? Cipher text ang tawag. I think you know this. So the process of writing from plain text to cipher text, we call it encryption. I think you're also familiar with this. Tama? Tama ba? Tama ba, guys? Ha? Huh? Hello?
Kasama na ano yan, sir?
Nang? Okay, now. So, just like this one, itong message na to na she walks in beauty like the night, ito ay from Lord Byron's poem daw, She Walks in Beauty. Okay. Ang ginawa niya, he wrote it in code. Ito yung naging code niya. Okay. So, ang ginagawa pala niya dito is we have what we call the cyclical coding scheme. Ito napakasimpleng way on how we can code your messages. So, ang ginagawa nito ay they just shifted the alphabet. Okay, in same positions, nag-move lang yung mga alphabet on a certain number. Okay, in this case, so from A, naging W siya, and B, naging X, and so on and so forth. Okay, we have this. Someone did the chat. Maganda daw yan para kay Crush. Okay, kaso, paano kung hindi maintindihan ni Crush mo to, edi mas lalong hindi kanya minahal. So dapat, ipaintindi mo rin siya, o ipaintindi mo rin ito sa kanya. Para sweet. Okay? Now, so, on the other hand, to decrypt naman, baliktad. So, from your ciphertext, we create a decoding scheme, and then we write it in plain text. Ang tawag natin dito ay decryption naman. So, if you look into this, ang ginawa dyan is you just shift to four positions. Okay, so, just like what we did dun kanina, di ba? From here, nag-move lang ng four positions kaya nagkaroon tayo ng ganong coding. Okay? So, cyclical encrypting is actually just the same thing with modular arithmetic. Na ang ginagawa natin dito is yung one, we call it, we denote it by one, and so on, until Actually, ang Z should be 26 pero dahil ang ginagawa natin should be 0, di ba? So, ang magiging 0 natin dito ay yung 26, which is yung Z. Okay? So, dahil doon, we can code Z to be, or pag 0, ibig sabihin is just 26 or anyone congruent to 0 mod 26. Can you follow? Malinaw po ito?
Opo.
Okay, now. So, ang ginagawa natin dito is we just code it of in a manner like P plus M, where P is the position of the letter and then yung M is the, we call it kung ano yung number of shifting na gagawin natin. Okay? So, kunwari, the word si she, kung titignan natin, si letter S ay 19, right? So, kaya ang P natin dito ay 19. Okay? And then kung kunwari ang gagamitin natin ay 22. 22 yung movement natin. So 22 position. So plus 22. Ang mangyayari dito, 19 plus 22 will be 41. Mod 26, it will be 15. So instead of letter S, ang gagamitin natin dyan ay O. Di ba? If you go back here, ang magiging 15th letter natin ay O. Okay? Kaya instead of using S, ang i-code natin si S, i-code natin siya as O. Okay? Can you follow?
Yes po, sir.
Yes po, sir. Okay.
Now, if we try to code, for example, naman si Catherine the Great using 11 as your M, yung ating shifting position is 11. So, ang gagawin lang natin dyan is, ito, I already have this. So, si Catherine, ito yung mga position ni C-A-T-H-E-R-I-N-E. So, which is 3, 1, 20, and so on. Ito yung mga positions niya. Tapos, nagdagdag ako, nag-shift ako ng 11, right? And then, ito yung magiging mga bagong position niya. And then, notice, I was able to rewrite Catherine into this. N-L-E-S-P-C-T-Y-P. Can you follow? So, kunwari, si C ay 3 kasi third letter. Plus 11, kaya naging 14. Ang 14th letter naman ngayon, ang 14th letter natin ay N. Kaya we code C as N. Can you follow?
Yes, please.
Okay. And so on. Kaya nagkaroon tayo. So if we try to code Catherine the Great, ito yung magiging code natin. NLSPTCY, so on and so forth. Okay? Malinaw?
Yes, sir.
Yes, po, sir.
Ito naman, paano naman natin di-decode? Ito medyo kaiba. Paano tayo mag-decode? Kung 11, alam natin na ang shifting natin ay 11, ano yung magiging formula natin? Dahil nag-move tayo ng 11, para ma-decode, ano gagawin natin?
Okay. 11 din, sir.
11, kaso, ano nangyari? We will go back by 11, right? So kung ito plus 11 yung gagawin natin sa encoding, sa decoding, anong gagawin natin? We do
minus 11,
di ba? But ang alam natin, ang minus 11, di ba, ang minus 11 is just doing positive 15, right? Can you follow? Tama ba? Kasi in negative 11 plus 26, that would just be 15, right? Or negative 11 is congruent to 15. So para hindi tayo maggagamit ng negative, mag-add na lang tayo ng positive value. Okay, and to do that, mag-add tayo ng 15. Okay? So si T ay 20th alphabet plus 15, which is ang naging bagong movement natin kasi yung minus 11 is the same as going plus 15. So 20 plus 15, so that would be 35, mod 26, that would be 9, and the ninth letter is I. Can you follow? Nasundan po?
Apo.
Yes, please.
Okay. And same thing with G. G is seventh letter. So plus movement natin na 15. So that would be 22. The same number. 22 is V. And so on so forth. If we try to continue, ang makukuha natin ito. And then if we try to do the other letters, ito yung magiging decode. Madi-decode natin, which is I want it terrible. Okay? Malinaw?
No, sir.
Apo.
Question po? Baka may tanong? So, ang ginawa natin basically is we just use shifting pag nag-code. There are still other ways, but ito lang ang i-ko natin para at least meron tayong alam paano mag-code and then decode using modular arithmetic. Okay? Okay, so that's it guys. So we'll see each other next week. Okay, but I'll end this first.